have to wait for Rosa. She's coming. Go, Edie.
Hi, Mom. It's me, Susie. What happened? What's the matter?
You're hurting her. But she's on the tube.
Oh, it's bleeding.
I know.
I'm so sorry.
I mean, I just got off the phone with one of my guests from my podcast who has been really good, supportive. He's been helping me through this with my mom and giving me advice.
There's a big problem with understaffing. It's at the root of every nursing home problem.
Staffing ratios for most skilled nursing facilities is absurd.
A nursing home can save as much as $1 million a year by keeping their staffing low. And then they keep the wages low and they make money on that.
You have massive profits going to the top, and at the bottom, you have elder abuse. You have development of pressure injuries, falls, dehydration, malnutrition, infections that become serious. All of that is going on at the nursing home level due to chronic understaffing.
Staffing is the root of all evil. You know, low staffing, it just really is.
So I'm a nurse in long-term care, and today I got put on the rehab unit, usually work dementia. One of the family members literally sat there and cried with me for a half an hour about how her mom is going to die here, and it made me bawl my eyes out. And she looks at me and she goes, "Do you guys just like not care?" I'm like, "It's not that. I definitely care. We cannot do everything. It's so messed up. My 12-hour shift, I get 25 minutes per person. The CNAs, they only work 8 hours. They get 8 minutes per person. We need to do better."
When she was 9, and then she had her own radio show when she was 16, like a big shot, in New York City on CBS, right? And then she belted out a song and he went, "Whoa, whoa, what? Who's singing that?" And they all said, "Her, the little one with the big voice." Right? That was you. Everyone loved Norma. Right? Yeah. Everyone. All the men. All the women, but a lot of men too. Am I right? And the autumn weather. She's singing. You singing with me? We just did the whole movie. Good? Goody, 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 good.
It's been really hard this whole 4 months, and I am a wreck from this, and trying to be strong for my mom.
No long-term care facility should allow a resident to get bed sores or other injuries because wounds are not being treated. That should be just taken care of routinely. And if it's not, somebody's not doing their job.
And I haven't been able to work, and I just feel unmotivated and I feel impotent to help my mom.
You got for me? What kind of words you got? Like maybe I love you? Like maybe yeah, I hear you. I hear you.
Oh, save the show.
What in the world? Like
I'm tired. And obviously depressed, and I feel like I've been going through her dying for the past 4 months because everyone's telling me that she's dying, but she doesn't die. But they're trying to make her die faster than she wants to.
You're dry? You have a dry throat? I know. That's from not having liquid. I'm gonna get you liquid right now, okay? I'm gonna get you juice.
Think about what it would feel like if you weren't allowed to drink for 2 days, 3 days, a week, 6 months. People need to start thinking about how that would feel, because if you live long enough, you're probably going to end up going through that.
A lot of times, it is fear on the side of the clinician. I don't want this person to choke and die. Well, that's what they hired you for, to help them to eat without choking and dying.
Good job, Mommy. Suck on it. Get the juice out. Good girl. Okay, now. Yeah.
And as a result, she's in pain because they're not taking care of her.
crazy because I'm there every day, and I still am fighting to get people to pay attention. So, and I'm also the enemy there now, and that doesn't feel good. So, it's really hard for one person to advocate, let alone I can't imagine the people that have no one to advocate.
Fighting for his dignity, for proper end-of-life care, was a horrible battle from hell.
And I'm calling, the nurse's station. There's no one picking up the damn phone.
My mother's death was a brutal death at the nursing home.
It falls upon each family that they have to watch the care that's being given and make sure that the facility isn't killing their loved one, because they will kill them to make more money.
The residents, or do we care about the finances of the healthcare industrial complex? And we have to look in the mirror and ask ourselves as a country, what are we going to do for our older adults, for our most vulnerable, for our loved ones? And I think that's why you're doing this documentary.